No Kobu. We're going right into it with Pyro. And this is the third time that they've played in top 8 this season alone. Samij has only dropped one game for Revenant so far in top 8 this
season. Got him with the 4-3. Over 30 frames of startup on the and very good whiff punish on Telekid.
Samij are looking dead even here. Very good cornering him, but the wake up teleport, we haven't seen that in an Ice Age here in MKX. Wake up teleport from Tarnia, and wow!
Oh, and that NJP slam dunk.
Doesn't get the conversion, but picks it right up with that NJP, and this is going to be chip out for Samij. So Revit looked at
Lady
full
Jordan.
Control until Samij got one hit in the corner, and bam, back in there.
My god. Okay, got him with the 4-2, very good conversion. By Samij, drop the ender there. He's got himself out of the corner.
Oh, right away, Samij finds his way in when Revit tried to build the full screen. Getting hit by the straight dagger, and the teleport with it gets Samij right into striking distance and just starting to run away with it now. Samij on.
I like that fake out.
Samij is on one of those rounds that we've seen against almost everyone. No matter who he plays, it could be at the highest level. He makes rounds look so fast against these top players.
Yes, he does.
And you can see the frames as they happen, frame by frame. They're going in.
Every frame tick. Oh, and got him with the 4-3 again. That's the second time after a telekick into Asai. He's got him with 4-3, and that's going to open up the 4-4 later on.
And pick it up right where we left off, and yeah, that usually crosses up. Somehow finds a way to make it not cross up and go into an air dagger. And a switch from Kobu, not looking good so far from Revit. And what a reversal from Samij to put Revit back to the corner going in round number 2 here. Revit is fully loaded with meter, but Samij one hit away from being fully loaded himself. These guys, both of them, full sticks of butter. We got ourselves a bake-off, but going right in. That was actually smart from Revit to put out the meaty through that fade. But Samij still has the meter lead. He's going to build almost a full bar there, but luckily blown up the gap is Revit.
Oh, very good whip punish. And a good NJP, a read on that fade, and that will shut it down. Oh my god.
And Revit, one of the, you know what, he's pretty much invented the instant air drill kick. This man uses it to perfection, and he does probably the best instant drill kick that we've seen in the scene.
I mean, you can't react to that. He's doing it so quick. 4-2-3, max up, telekick, block, very good. By Revit, just waiting for that side to go over. Okay, a little bit too patient there.
Oh, and
we almost saw it again, a back two.
Yeah, for once, doesn't get it. I mean, that one right there, that converts into pressure, even if they block and on hit. Usually gets the entire conversion, which he reacts to and gets full coverage. Stop that! And we got ourselves a scramble right now, and they're not even close to death. We're in a scramble situation midway through the round. Very rarely seen.
He has 3 bars. He can telekick into an x-ray, go for the ultimate gimmick, and go up 2-0.
Oh, but he has no break here! That's gonna close it out!
Oh,
he's not dead yet!
That doesn't kill. Oh my god.
Not like this!
Punish. Right there.
Not like this, ladies and gentlemen. And he beats to it! Oh my gosh! He actually meaties! Guys, that's only game 2. That's only the first match of the night. Don't go anywhere. Strap yourselves in. You guys need to make some popcorn. Pop it now. But we don't go anywhere, because we're just getting warmed up here.
Okay, Samij has got to be in Revit's head at this point. Very good punish there. 10%. Dusted him up.
And playing a very mobility-heavy
playstyle
now is Revit. And you got to be careful against Melina because she can strike anywhere on the screen at any time. And an odd choice from Revit to go back to Pyro after doing so well with Kobu, and it's already paying off early.
You know, maybe he got away with a few gimmicks that he didn't want to continue this set with, because he does have to come back 3 games.
Samij should know not to test that instant drill kick with a high of all things. That woman is low profiling into the ground.
Yes, sir.
And there we go. Kind of an auto hit confirm with that fade from Samij, and this will be some good damage. It's going to set up a cross up or non cross up attempt. Nope, he just decides to.
Board 1-4. 1-2-3, that's plus 2.
And he almost built another bar that string alone.
Revit smart though, he's out of the corner. He's out of the corner. He's still got a bar. Samij also has a bar, though they're pretty much even in meter at this point. Here we go. Samiji on set point. Revit trying to keep himself into this.
And one too many fireballs, as Melina does have that projectile. She's a decent zoner herself, and one of the best anti-zoners in the game. And a savage flip kick from Revit.
Yes, sir.
Getting healthy, but Samiji still has one bar, which is one fade, which is all he needs to get back into any match.
An input error cost him all that damage. He went for the drill kick and just got a jump in kick. And this is going to be close to doing it.
And actually got the punish there, Samiji. Oh, it's standing up.
Oh, no, he's early. Raised up. Oh, my God, such a hard. No.
He does go with Sector, but I think that mind game does. Against Dragon forced Dragon to think that Sonic was going to pick something different. And Dragon now on Bone Shaper instead of Impossible, still playing lights out. Cyclops has two bars, he has
into
to watch out.
Restand.
And just swinging in Sonic there.
Okay, tried to jump. Dragon is all over every option.
But never count out Sonic. He's got him cornered. There's going to be some 2-on-2 pressure. Nope, goes in with 1-1-1-2, and there is a gap, and Dragon gets out of there beautifully.
Yeah, Trockets gets hit. This is going to close it out for the first round.
And Dragon, even though this may not be the pick you want on paper, still looking incredibly good. Oh, and that's going to be a whip punish with 4-4. Back into the corner with the scoop and the shimmy into 4-4. That
shimmy,
is the
boy.
Shinnok special. That shimmy has caught us all.
A 7-frame low with that shimmy. It's so good. Oh, down 2 into the overhead.
Ooh.
Dragon. Oh, okay. Very good whip punish by Sonic. Can't do that here.
Sometimes it's scary when they whip right in your face, and you're not too sure if you even blocked it or not. But good recognition from Sonic to see that whip right in front of him and catch him twice with the back 3. And what a tick.
Good tech.
Getting out of jail for free is Sonic Fox with 2 back dashes. Now he's got the full screen to play with and a teleport not to worry about. And he gets aggressive instead of trying to close this out full screen.
Oh my God, that was so close to a whip punish. Dragon recognized it, went for it. But that third kick just caught him by the toes.
And just like last match, this is the third meetup between these two here in season number 2. Dragon won the first match between these two in season number 2, 3-2. And then Sonic won the run back in week 6, 3-2.
2 weeks after final round, after Dragon won offline, Sonic came back 2 weeks later and took the crown back.
And Dragon getting the lead early, but Sonic running away with it now. Puts on the auto lock.
Ooh.
Good game, sir. That's game number 1.
Go up 1-0 here. Now it's on Dragon. Tie this thing back up. Very nice down 1.
Oh, very good.
And Shinnok, one of the few characters you gotta respect after those pokes. Because that Hellspark could be coming any minute.
And Dragon's going to get the mix going early and blocking the overhead right away as Sonic. Something that was definitely a downfall of his at final round is that those overheads were starting to work for Dragon, which is so rare. And that's something
that's very rare. Dragon usually is one of the only people to always crouch that second hit.
Oh, and just checking Dragon. Trying to go for something with the Hellsparks, and maybe he missed the late meter burn. That's going to chip out, but if there's any consolation prize, he's out of the corner and within 4-4 range already to check him. Instead, goes for the block and crouches it, but looks like he got a stand 4 instead of a 4-4. What an input error from Dragon.
Good God, the down 2.
Ooh, and trying to catch Sonic pressing a button, but Sonic refusing to play the counterpoke game against that Hellspark. So smart to do, is that Hellspark is the counterpoke killer. And Sonic Fox now on the offensive.
That backdash into a trip guard was so good by Sonic. Stamp switch tech.
On the defensive now, trying to play the full screen game, trying to make Dragon make a mistake and come to him. He's got the health lead. That's fighting game basics 101. And now that he has closed the gap, backdashing out of the Hellspark range.
No real reason for Sonic Fox to have to come in. Tracking missile. Goes for the overhead. Gets stuck. Into the restand.
Sonic's going to see
what's the mix.
Yep. Out of the same that thing, you eat all that damage, just to make sure, because if you block the next guy, and he had the bar to burn, and that should be chipped
yes,
out.
He it, did. Death,
I think he could have gone for the trance there, and then the chip out to keep him in the corner, but you know what? A W's a W, a round's a round.
And neither one of them have any meter right now. Catches them with the overhead.
What a whiff punish from Sonic God, Fox! Insane play that we're witnessing here in Sonic Fox. Just taking the breath out of Dragon every time he's tried to get a health lead and establish a lead here in this match.
JP, very good crouch by Dragon. Burns the bar. What's the mix? Will he go for that overhead one more time? Goes for the 4-4, and that is a straight punish. Sonic is up 2-0. Will he call Echo Fox's scar in?
He keeps it classy and no calling. Sonic Fox, that might have been an input. But the fact that he already hit with a trance means that he could combo off overhead or low. Usually if Shinnok has no meter, you only have to worry about that overhead, as he's not going to get any damage off of that low. But the fact that he had a launcher off of both made it a true mix-up. And now it's such a clutch block from Sonic Fox, and already getting him cornered. He's going to get some missiles on the screen. He has two bars of meter, so I fully expect... there's some hidden missiles, but the EX missile might come into play early as he's built so much bar already.
Oh my god. A run-up throw really shows that Dragon is really apprehensive to really hit a button right now.
Oh, here we go. Sonic Fox is playing the space so well, and that's going to close it out.
Oh my god.
A very good going with the kick that had the actor frames on there to linger as Dragon was falling away. Sonic Fox playing lights out, spacing immaculate right now. Dragon trying everything he can now to get back in this match.
Dragon's got to fight for his life, and that is a block on the overhead. That is a full punish. 27% missiles. Backdashes into the... Oh my god, Sonic, please. And Sonic's playing it so well because he'll hit, finish the combo, get back to full screen, make Dragon play that game again, restand.
Hasn't gone for throw one time yet. Shocking at this point, but catches Sonic pressing a button back in the mix.
He could go for it here. 16% would be huge.
And
teched,
exactly. Just like that. Sonic Fox, master of reads. Keeping it safe. And all.
Oh, that is a full punish. Very good by Dragon. Being patient. He had the read that EX flamethrower was coming.
Oh!
And Jesus Christ, the reaction tosses him towards the corner.
No full conversion.
Oh no!
And barely!
Oh, the overhead whiff punish!
Sonic barely made it over that. That does have some decent anti-air properties, but man, Sonic Fox now in a territory where he can try to clutch this out, and Dragon not pressing button again. As Sonic Fox had the bar to do the same exact step he did before with the EX flamethrower.
Dragon has no meter. Just got it. Using that Hellspark. Just built it. Health is just about even. One bar, Sonic Fox. EX missile can come in at any point.
And walking right into that.
The EX flamethrower, good tech by Dragon.
And once again,
the reaction.
You know what? I like that from Dragon though. He says, I'm going to test your reactions because if you don't get this, it's my game. And here comes Scar coming in for the tag team brutality.
Yes.
Rewind.
Exactly.
And we're going in. Deoxys going with Assassin over Mournful in this matchup. And already catching him with what I believe the back one for. And this
nice.
Is some big damage.
And this corner carry. The 10-minute combos by the Princess herself. Dropped it. Run up throw.
And dropped.
Oh, very good block.
Dropped combo. Still gets 41%. That's a Savadinia. And ooh. That was a long whiff on that machine gun, but Deoxys wasn't able to get there in time. He did not have his stamina. Wow, barely getting over that
just
up rocket.
Just barely missed the fucking...
Rewind had the read there. Oh, and jumping out of plus frames, the down one.
No, sir.
Big ol' hitbox on that is going to end that no full combo. Forcing the break. And Rewind at a huge disadvantage here. Look at the spacing from Deoxys getting around this zoning with quite ease and not getting the backdash out as Rewind.
You know, that's one thing... Katana has some really good normals that make it a hard time for Jackie because she has such short limbs. But things like that 4-2. Oh, Very good, up rockets.
Into 31%, into a knockdown. He catches him with the back, into another back three.
Oh my god. Mix. Oh, he doesn't get the float. But that's going to do it anyway. Rewind. Answer him back really, really quick.
That's Nerfan to try to get any kind of plus frames to get out of this corner. Deoxys, but putting himself in the corner is Rewind, but luckily the end of the projectile catches Deoxys pressing the button. And we're back to the full screen game. We'll look how much meter Deoxys has. If he can get
half of
Rewind's health gone, that X-ray is going to be coming, baby.
A lot of drop combos, especially towards the end of these combos, a lot of drops. But any moment, that X-ray could be coming when he burns the meter.
That may come back to bite Deoxys if he is unable to take this.
He's got to be really careful. Okay, it's going to be some good damage.
Rewind's not going to be able to break until most of the damage is done. It goes for a nice little...
Oh my god!
I don't even know what kind of setup that was, but it hit Rewind, and there we go. Deoxys with a T-Magnet combo, and he says...
Hey, I'm just kidding.
He says... We've seen Reptile, I mean, all over the place. But going back to his bay, Splicer, Raiden, getting the first hit, has that bar. It does come in handy when you're Splicer with that EX teleport. That can be so tricky.
It really can. And he uses it so well. He doesn't use it all the time to where it's readable. Okay, we're going to the corner here. 35%. Run up. Whip the low. Oh, no anti-air there.
Yeah, and holding that pressure, Rewind, even though he had two bars. Oh, if he would have committed there, would have gotten some decent damage. He didn't have the stamina for the full convert.
Oh, and a very good. I don't know if that was a reaction. It's a little bit too quick, but either way, low. Mix,
three in a row, mix, into the
mix,
throw.
Into a throw.
Now we may have seen everything here.
Very nice.
Back three into throw, and it all hit. That was some savagery right there.
Down one, no. Crossover. Teleport. The Ox is back in the corner again, where it all began. Very nice little stagger there from Deoxys.
Great anti-air with that
very
forward
nice forward walk.
And a huge conversion here. Went in the back one in the trade, and he had a little more plus frames there. Then Katana then was able to still generate some pressure.
No, that was actually a full combo there. Back one traded with most normals. If you trade back one, you can still combo off of
that
it.
Is
which is
disgusting.
What
nerf this character
oh, it's so
into
good.
The drown. We need
it's
one
so
more
good.
Patch
it's
NRS.
Like plus...
One more patch NRS. This is ridiculous.
It's plus. They changed it a little bit after the last patch, but it's about plus 20 something. You trade with anything. Oh my god! Oh. And almost a chip. Not like this.
Great final
very
block.
Very nice.
From Rewind and the reversal teabag. We got ourselves a match, guys. 1-1. Teabags all around. I have
the
seen
slow, methodical teabag.
I have to wear these odd mix-ups are actually catching Deoxys off guard because it's different from what he normally sees from Rewind. And what a swing
absolutely.
With 1-1-1 to contest the forward four.
That forward four, even though it low crushes, you are airborne. So if Katana hits you with a fan, you're going to be comboed. That was plus the 1-1-2. Deoxys not having it. Corner switch. Lift. 31%. Sharpens up. Very smart. Oh, got him with the jump in three.
I like that. That was actually a safe check
oh
as an anti-air attempt. Oh, but it was not close enough for that 4-4, which adds so much damage to that combo.
All these lows, my goodness. Oh, oh my god, I don't know what happened. He crouched the throw and then went for a down two and it whipped.
Oh,
and that is going to do it for that rail.
He had nothing to back that up with and he didn't even cancel the down one. He just did a down one and then DP'd. Savagery. And
those down threes.
I have a confirmation from our admins is that we are considering a rule that if you don't teabag, you will DQ a game.
Whoa. Now that's pretty savage, I have to say. Look at all these down ones. The mix-up game here is real. Down one, shocker,
ooh,
or just down one. Very nice run-up.
I think that was a missed instant fantasy. He got that NJP out there and trying to throw into a vicinity blast. Rewind respecting. But finally gets out of the sneak back. That would have been some great damage if Jax was able to come up, but that damage boost is going to linger around. And the raw DP again! It works! No DP has worked other than randomly. What is going on here? And that should kill. And Deoxys is going to take the next game. Do we get some T-back? Nope.
Ooh, even slower. My goodness. Like molasses. Or you're behind her and you get a full combo. The vicinity blast in that situation, just not that great.
And I really like that Rewind has checked these jump-ins with forward one. Where Atlantire, if he doesn't float, and he's safe. If he does float, it just recovers. Keeps nice and simple, 33%. Oh, it tries to get aggressive off the interactable. But that teleport is going to be a constant mind game for Deoxys, and some more big damage in the corner.
36%. Willy Sharpen, no jumping, float into a throw. It's Tech down one into a fan, and Raiden can actually punish Katana fans. Back two is blocked, and Deoxys is on set point with almost three bars. There it is. Third bar achieved. X-Ray can come at any moment. And there's two bars gone just like that. Rewind opting not to break. Everything is on the line right now. Regular teleport. Conversion, no! Down one. Out of the throw. You see pokes get thrown a lot. And that one just didn't. Back one, one. Hit confirmed. That does combo. 31%.
Thank you.
Very nice. Forward one.
Just swatting her out of the air with that forward one, and a nice little conversion with the corner push to the other direction. That down one's range has been such a problem for Rewind this entire match.
Oh my goodness. He's got to break. No option. Oh, and that was so risky to jump against Katana with all that meter. No down one. Jump back. No anti-air. He is going to get chipped out just watching Deoxys.
And the Grinder here at the Combat Cup, always playing week in and week
okay,
out.
Yeah.
Thrills across the board over Quizman, Cyclone to get in the top eight, and Illusions.
Oh my god, Aquaman, please. You missed that stanky. Oh my god, that was so good.
If you think that I'm surprised at the savage stanky legs from Young Monster at this point, you are mistaken. This man with stanky legs. Oh, it doesn't get to confirm!
No, the basilisk. Backdash!
Oh no. Illusions. What the best in the business? I think he covered the basilisk in the full combo. This time he's trying to think that he blocked it in backdashes. That was kind of a preemptive backdash. And we're even here. Backdash there. And what another stanky leg!
Illusions has been using the slide to come in and just get a poke in right under those guns, not being a problem, but Young Monster says, you know what? I don't need the guns. Up one round so far. I like this pick from Illusions. Very good block. And a good punish, too. I want to add that in because that slide and that dash, sometimes you see it go unpunished. I'm guilty of it. Stanky, like Jesus Christ.
I mean, we saw it from the highlight reel from Sunday. Four stanky legs in a row. And another one! Why not? Hashtag another one, guys. These stanky legs already from Young Monster putting on a performance. Jackie Bay, he's got the great fast zoning tools, especially with that kick. We're going to say that
he
kick
does have
a whole
the
lot here.
Yep.
He's got a great meter build. But a big drop early from Illusions.
Another drop. We've seen so many drops tonight. Goes for the low scoop. Young Monster all over it. 20%. Float cancel. Again.
And just Ross.
And there it is.
Into the corner and the 50-50 working out.
Over it.
Very good start from Illusions, getting Young Monster off that bar where that miss can go into such damage.
Oh, and just caught him, not pressing the button, got him right there. Solid by Illusions. Young Monster just not holding block at the right spots. Tries to backdash those guns. There's four bullets there. 4-3, very good answer to that.
And the kick hitting
Young Monster
wherever he goes, the boot. Wants a piece of Jackie tonight. Hard knockdown, gets the meter build. What's going to be the mix? It goes with 1-2, that tricky low. That comes so fast off. That's that one in the raw trance.
God.
some of the magic.
That is negative 1 billion on block.
Some of the magic that we see from illusions with Quan. Fast as Young Monster took that very first game. And now Young Monster wants to bully him in block stun as he picks high tech Jackie. But if illusions can keep him away. Oh man, oh man.
Yeah, he does have the absorb.
Oh, barely getting out of the plus.
Had to get him
off the big boot.
That 4-3 is so good. But here we go, dashes in, gets low scoop, down 3, into the overhead, block. He did it for the Vine, and it worked. Didn't commit. Pressure.
Very good, and the anti-air down 3 stand 4. The anti-air Quan special, fantastic stuff from Illusions. He hasn't had to deal with any of the block stun from High Tech, and the one time he did, perfectly read it after the 1-2-1-2 into stand 4. With the back dash.
Illusions has thrown out this down 3 so often, it recovers so quick. By the time Young Monster reacts, Illusions already going into buttons. Very nice, NJP, corner switch. Knockdown, pressure. Oh, tried to stanky leg. Expected him maybe to NJP. It completely whiffed, break. And there's a down 3 again, into the high-low mix.
And getting him with the
Oh my god.
And Illusions is going to take the lead here. 2-1. As long as he does not drop this combo, I have been known for the commentator's curse before, but he is indeed going to close it out. And Illusions of 2 into Conquest tomorrow.
Love him or hate him, man. Young Monster and his brother, very good players, very good competitors. You can't count this man out just yet. And he went back to full auto. But yeah, you got to be careful with those guns. That 4-3 is going to get you. And that's such a smart pick by Illusions, just to have that option. Ooh!
And didn't have any stamina, but used the cancel on the normal to get up and get the 50-50 quick. And luckily, Illusions didn't have the bar, but these mixes from Illusions have been working this
entire match. Down 3 into mix. He was doing the down 3 overhead in the last match. This one, down 3 into the low starter. Throwing Young Monster completely off. And a jump, the reaction. My god, the jump back. Round 2,
fight. Illusions have been making up so well, and those boots have been so effective.
Ooh.
And finally, a blocked scoop, but he did not punish fully. He only got the 1-1. And these mids, though, have hit almost 100% on Illusions, trying to get the mix. And Young Monster pressing buttons. Which is exactly what Jackie's buttons against Quan is exactly what you want to do. Her buttons, I mean, Quan up close struggles. I mean, even though they gave him a 6-frame down one, he doesn't even get anything guaranteed off it mix wise.
He's only plus 2, I think. Yeah.
And that's on hit. So even if he hits you with a down one, you swing on that man. You mash down one right back at him. I'm telling you, just mash a poke against that down one on hit. Don't let him get any mix now. If you get hit with a down 3, different story.
Yes.
Good luck. Have fun.
Absolutely. Oh, got him with the low scoop. Down 3. And caught him trying to jump out into the trance. Young Monster can break. And that is all of his meter. Illusions has 2 bars. Illusions on set point. Young Monster about 15% health. Down 3. Blocks the mix. Delayed room. Jump back. Still got him. It's a down 2.
This is,
if you witness me getting beat by it, the back 1-2.
Hey-o.
My goodness.
Alright, this is a battle between the number 1 and 2 highest win percentages of the entire season, the entire Combat Cup, at Samiz with a 79.51% win percentage, Sonic with a 79.13% win percentage.
Jesus.
That could change depending on how this match goes. Sonic Fox. Charge first blood, and we saw that.
Ooh.
That was one of the first times we ever saw it was on Sunday where he went for the quick rise setup. But Samiz did his homework, I guess, and simply faded out of it.
All right, into the throw. 12% health left by Samiz, sitting on 2 bars. 2-1, EX fade, throw.
Raw!
Oh, and a gunshot right in the face!
And took the gap out. Samiz definitely wanted to fade through that. Wow, Sonic Fox, great reads early, up one round. And they, in fact, met four times in season number one, all in grand finals. 3-2, 3-2, 3-2, 3-1, splitting it 2-2 in grand finals.
So this is the tiebreaker right here. Oh, that was such a good crossover right there by Sameet.
And what a conversion with that gigantic down one. I wasn't even sure if that was going to convert or not. Sneeze with his instant run down ones are so fun to watch.
Very nice fade right there. Burn the bar to close this round out. We're tied up one round apiece.
Immediately in Sonic's favor, he's got to watch out for EX guns, EX nut punches. And you know what? Ever since Sunday, apparently, you got to watch out for these down three X-rays.
Oh no! Smeesh does that so often where he'll just throw a fade out and hold it. Oh, and very nice wake up EX fade. Could be some decent damage here. Fades back. Back 1-2, down 3, plus 2, into the side.
I don't know about that fade.
Oh, goes to the overhead.
Right in place. Might have, with that fade, tried to catch Sonic Fox going for a back 1. To go for the whip punish behind and getting hit by the baton. This is not good for Sameej.
And by the way, I'll say it after 4-2-3. Slam, dunk, down one, into the roll, cross up. Oh my god, neutral jump kick back 2-2, whip punish.
And clutching it out is Sameej. Let's see what happens here in game number two between these two. Whipping it down 4. And Sameej checking pretty late, but still catches him with the stagger to get that first bar of health. That's a good trade. One bar for a bar, as long as your opponent doesn't get it. What a whip punish again!
Jesus. That back 2, so good. Such a good advancing mid. Down 3. 1-2-3. Into the side. Back 2 again! And Sonic just blocking so much! One straight hit is gonna do it for Sameej here. Oh, and a raw flip kick.
Sameej, looking at those 3 bars of health, didn't phase him one bit in that very first game. So, normally that's not like to say, look at the meter, but like Sameej almost took that out of me as he went into the final round of last game, solo on meter. The reads and force Sonic to break immediately, and we'll see if that happens here. Anti-air flip kick raw!
Very good anti-air.
And doesn't even spend the bar to guarantee the mix to Sonic Fox. He's confident right now. Oh, and the flip and the teleport hitting behind Cassie, who has one of these smallest hitboxes, triggering people since day one of MKX.
I agree. I've been there. Both of them. Oh, JP on the way down. You very rarely see that from a Melina. Alright, what's the mix? Jump in. Into a throw. Sonic trying to tie this up here. One round apiece.
That was an instant air gun if I've ever seen one. That was so fast it caught Sameej slipping. And now both of them, no stamina. Oh, and a lot of lifts from Sameej.
Oh my god, right in the face. 2-1.
Oh no!
Oh my god, and he hit him with the forward 1-2. And that's going to do it. Sameej up 2-0.
Of all things. Stagger tool as well to make it a guessing game if that low is going to come or not, and then she can just generate even more pressure off of it.
Oh, very good standing one anti-air. Doesn't roll with the flip kick. 26%, nothing guaranteed. Into the back 1-2. And Sonic just having a hard time opening Sameej up. He's went for so many throws back 2-2.
Oh, come off the bar, Sameej. Wanted to get back into this round, but now things are looking good for Sonic. Trying to take this round and take that meter into a potential final round. But Sameej.
Oh my god, and the whip punish! Sonic had everything on his side. You can see how much health he had left when he made the exit, and now he doesn't have the health lead anymore. No thrills working on this man.
And simply gonna chip out, but you know what, Sameej? Came off resources and got Sonic Fox off even more. That's where I like it. Sameej never gives up, and he always, even if he has just one bar, and wow, still
Oh my god, that was so fun.
The second hit whiffed completely, but there's still enough hits done to complete that combo. This is getting crazy, folks.
Run up throw, good tech by Sonic. Just got him out of the startup with the side, and finally, a throw works for Sonic.
He overcommits when Samish has the bar. And that is a guessing game of stuff, and that down one!
Oh my god.
That is an anti-aircraft ballistic missile if I've ever seen one. That down one swipes out of the air. Swiper, no swiping around here. And fading through the gunshots, Samish is styling out, but he's so low on meter. And Sonic Fox has a lot to play with right now.
If he run up throws again, it will be the most savage thing. Very good poke. Sonic sitting on so many bars. And an air-to-air with the instant air guns.
And all of them are working right now.
Oh my god.
That just shows you that Samish is a little impatient. Coming up in the neutral a little too early. This is going to guarantee chip out if he wants to. And just like that. That does so much chip, guaranteed there is.
Instant air guns right there, point blank.
And
run up throw.
And it's so scary because if Sonic Fox gets comfortable and if he starts giggling, he becomes even more dangerous. So that instant air gun in the neutral that hits you point blank in the face, that's going to give Sonic a little bit of confidence. I tell you, I know personally, if he giggles, game blouses.
The overhead to keep it safe. Jump and kick, the roll does not have distance. Oh my god, that whiff punish on the poke. Run up throw by Samij. Oh, NJP completely whiff, but no punish by Sonic. Won't close it out. Oh, very good. Oh, okay. Situations like that, man, especially tonight, just make me so tense. We've seen too many instances where somebody just drops the ball.
And back-to-back drops from both of these guys. Sonic Fox actually had a whiff punish, but didn't get it fully. Using the hit stun off the gun. Throwing in the mix with the throw. And Samish hasn't gotten anything off the fades in a while here. And Sonic Fox, the throws are working against Samish, who's usually so good at teching them.
Oh my goodness, this Samish just... Okay, fades out. He's trying to find his footing here.
Instant air gun. One more throw. Play. One more throw. EX gun. Instant air gun. Sonic Fox.
He can EX gun at any point right now.
It cut.
Oh my god, the 4-2.
And Sonic isn't going to break here. Confident in his play that he can just simply wait, take his turn, and close it out.
Oh, he made him burn the meter. Sonic has one more bar. And there it is. Tied 2-2.
He's just going to sit there in the back and pray for buffs until one of these men ruins his night.
Okay, no. Oh my goodness. It went with the normal committed and got that 28%. Dashes in. Jump back.
And now it's Samish who's catching Sonic Fox impatient in that about sweet distance and maybe even further with those daggers. It's catching Sonic trying to come in and nice conversion without any bar there. Samish and got caught with the back one, trying to find his way in. And Sonic Fox so good with those stamina-less conversions with that down forward low kick. Okay, pressing buttons!
Oh and wow! My god.
Out of nowhere, Samish taking that and puts Sonic in the corner. This is potentially match point for Samish.
1, 2, 3, plus two, back two. Oh, didn't hit confirm, no roll after that.
Lifting going on, and that's been the frightening space between these two, is Cassie's back one range. I mean, so much has happened in that range. We've seen instant air guns, we've seen size, we've seen whiffed back ones, we've seen everything with, and the whiff punishes have been fantastic. The push between these two, perfect, and just like there, the whiff punish, it's been fantastic. It's been nothing but the best.
Okay, caught him with a low flip kick. EX nut punch, what is the mix? Overhead keeps it safe. Oh, so smart by Sonic. Just go with a down three, and the instant air guns ties it up. Last round, match five.
And just like that, that instant air gun out of nowhere, catching Samish off guard. It's caught him off guard so many times, and even trading there with the regular. And wait, just in his face. Why not? It's worked so far. Why stop now? The back one luckily gets him out of eating the hit stun off of that teleport. Cyfox not gonna be, does break here. It looked like he didn't. And now both of them, no meter, no stamina, but has to watch out for the fade. Luckily didn't overcommit, only put one normal out on the screen. Still smart from Sonic.
2-1-4. Very good counter pokes with a grab. Block the string, it's barely negative. Negative 5, 2-1-4.
And he's gonna get
Sonic running away with this.
And get,
oh my god, one mix away. Oh, and he, Samish, please. 4-3 plus 2. And that is chip out. Sonic Fox is moving on to grand finals.
Wow.
To his own mind. We'll see what happens here. Jump back into the booty.
Oh, and doing a little bit of a gimmick. Early Solutions down one into a rune to start us off here.
And Sorcerer is something we've not seen from Illusions tonight. And oh my god, just got him out of the air, which is something not a whole lot of characters can do anything about.
And for Illusions, if he wins this, he will have to play Sonic Fox in Grand Finals. Illusions has made Grand Finals this season, where he got 3-0'd by Sonic Fox.
Okay, DP pressure, very good block, no punish.
So unfortunate.
And you can see, Jesus, Illusions, please. He knew when that armor was coming back. And the down three trying to, oh my god, the Ox is trying to get out of the corner, and that down three just so good. And the down one, not, oh my god.
And usually converting with, wow, he still gets him in the back three, and now he took Deoxys' chance to break. It's still going on, and even if he hits him with some more specials, taking even more meter is Illusions.
The vortex. I love when Illusions does that. You never know when it's coming. It just happens.
What a whiff punish.
Very
back
good
one.
Whiff punish.
That is Quan's best whiff punish tool. That back one has such forward range. And now he puts up the safety net in the portal, and that's going to close it out. Illusions, so close with this character. The meter ceiling portal, because I want to know. Red, 0%. I already know that.
Yeah, that's one that you kind of forget is even an option. Goes with the overhead. The runes, no whiff punish there. Jackie could have done the 4-2. Oh, and the down three got her out. Oh my god, that was so good. Wasn't able to capitalize.
This is a really good pick from Deoxys. You see, he can shred that armor. But it's still going to come down to how well Illusions plays. He has been looking crisp tonight, folks. Especially with Quan. And
all these bullets.
And we've seen this matchup even with Young Monster, and they've gone down to the wire. And if...
Oh, and set it up right in his face, just barely got it.
And even if this works out, Illusions has that reptile at his back. Deoxys, I don't know if he wants to break here. He does. And one mix all takes, and if he would have read that, he could have got a machine gun and gotten to have potential chip out territory. Stanky Leg neutral.
Crossover, it goes for the grab. No.
And that was another risk from Illusions to even go for that back three into the room, especially if Deoxys would have read that, blocked it right, could have armored it, and actually killed Illusions. Scary stuff all around, guys.
Mixed him with the low. EX. Runes. Puts himself back next to the portal. Loads it up again, baby. Deoxys has to find some sort of footing in this. He's got all the meter he could want.
Oh, and a big
one. Oh, goes overhead.
And that is it. Illusions up 2-0, looking so solid here. Deoxys has never won with Jackie in a top 8 here in season number 2. He's picked Jackie. There's also things that you really can't control, which are some of the things that Illusions does that, on paper, may not be the thing that someone at a high level would tell you to do, but Illusions, he's just a little bit of a savage. I mean, that's all I'm going to say.
He is one of the bigger savages we have here in the Combat Cup, that's for sure. But we've seen this man pick Sun God.
He's going to get the conversion, he does not.
Almost.
Again! The entire stand one after he drops it. The confidence to keep throwing those normals. Deoxys not checking him on the drop, and that rune slowing down time here. Looks like it even backed out. This man with the money pit in the corner. This is so dangerous for Deoxys.
Oh my god.
What Deoxys did not attempt was a DP there to double hit Quan. But he ate way too much damage in the process before he finally found his way out. And this is chip out territory. If you're Illusions,
yes, it is.
One round away from Grand Finals.
Deoxys just kind of stuck there in block from the majority of that round. Three very good anti-air. Deoxys is still in this. He's still got his wits about him. No sharpen, jump in. Oh, and just barely.
No confirmation into the fan, though. I don't know if that's input error or not. Huge drop, but that's okay. Picking it right back up. And that's going to do it for this round. Illusions is going to hold on to that bar going into the final round. Now, this is the Savage of Illusions. Watch out for EX Trance. At some point in this round, I'm calling it. I'm feeling it. Unless he puts him in the corner, never mind.
He does have three bars.
And this is another rune in the corner. This is completely different. This is just going to be an offensive blitz we're about to see
here. Deoxys has to get out of this. He can't block forever. Good blocks, though, on the mix. Got caught by the overhead. He just got two bars. Jump back. Breaks immediately.
And the armor already back up for Illusions. Now Deoxys is going to think about it.
Oh, no! Okay. You have to play smart here in the stop drop.
So disgusting. Anything like that, he has the advantage.
Absolutely. Just let it hit, you get the full punish. Oh, and Sonic with the read. Instant. Oh, that was almost a whip punish, and Illusions committed. And the armor portal let him just fall out of that combo, but it was at the end of it anyway. The mix good down one. Oh, and the far rune. Just an input error there from Illusions. Okay, shake it off. Round two. Sonic really ran away with that round, but
this is definitely
very good down three.
This is definitely an adjustment pick from Illusions, as in their last encounter, Illusions was up 2-0 on Sonic's Aaron Black with Reptile, and then Sektor reverse 3-0-ing Illusions against his Reptile, so that is definitely why he is not going Reptile right out of the gate here, and this is where he wants to be, cornered with the money pit. You do not press a button against that money pit, sir. It is going to rain all day. And so are these mixes. Here we go.
A mix. And he can set this up. Oh, he might actually kill. No, sets up the portal. He can go for chip out. Very good down three. That covered pretty much all the options. Sonic couldn't teleport, couldn't jump. He could have just blocked low and it wouldn't have killed, but regardless, very good backdash out of that gap.
And didn't commit to that back two. Very rare from Illusions, and the trade knew that he was going to fall out during that portal and swung. Illusions has the best recognition with portals I've ever seen.
Yeah, you can see him get hit and lose that hit of armor, and he almost has the timer ticking down in his head of when that armor's coming back, and he'll just let go a block.
There we go, coming with back two and getting him with the raw 50-50. Sonic Fox is not going to have enough to break here.
Breaker.
Even on the knockdown.
This won't kill. This won't kill. Armor could be coming. Oh my god, no, not like this. Illusions.
And he had the armor there, and it went away as it... First game in these sets gives you the advantage in the counterpick war. And oh, that was such a good swing from Sonic. To contest.
Ooh.
That rune. Oh my gosh. Sonic Fox.
Oh, and dropped a combo. That could have been very bad. And it turns out it was, but not because of the drop. Overhead. Oh, very good recognition by Illusions. Jump out of that command grab. Got him with a low. Overhead. And jumped out of the grab again. Illusions. Sonic has no meter. Finish this combo into...
Oh, and he dropped it! Does it get the hard knockdown? That's twice now, and doesn't get the launch on the rune. Very good from Sonic Fox, blowing up the gap. That's one of the few people that I've seen so far tonight. Again, he's... Oh my gosh! That lead out the wake up! What is happening right now? And before the breaker comes at down two, it looks like you need to stop. I'm actually freaking out a little bit. Whoa! Whoa!
That happened way too quick. That was not supposed to happen, Sonic.
Happiness.
Six shooters. 33%. With a very good hit confirmed. Sonic has not lost touch with this character. Big damage. 37%. Oh my god, all these stray hits, stray combos.
It's gonna be the burst for the kill? And he does not, he says, I'm gonna hold on to it. And here we go. Almost even on meter. Both of them loaded with the breaker. Sonic Fox looking really good in round number two. Illusion's really good. Round number one with the insane comeback. And puts on the couch drops. And,
ooh,
wow, what an anti from Illusion's. He did not want to be a part of the achievement named after this man with that special move.
And Illusion's just dropping so many BMBs right here.
So many opportunities for that portal have been denied. And puts it out anyway. Raw midstream.
Good. Backdash again.
If
jump back again.
This is where if he was Warlock, he'd be able to blow it up. And Skydrop is unblocked for right now from Illusions. What is going on here? And no hit confirm in the trance.
And no trance.
If Illusions wins this, he has no right with all of these drops.
This is not what you want to see if you're a fan of Illusions in this matchup. It's all these drops because Sonic would actually be dead at this point.
And finally,
and Illusions goes with it.
He goes up with that, and wow. Illusions, if he didn't drop, that looked like...
Dropped so many combos that that's what cost him everything. He played the way he was supposed to. Oh, and that could be a whip punish. No.
Didn't have the stand make there, and the raw acid bubble is going to anti-air. Is he going to get out? Another Basilisk? He does. And this zoning, so hard to deal with. It's coming even slower, and the acid spit is coming even faster, it seems. Very good meter burn on that. That stops all forward momentum. And Illusion's playing perfect right now. With Reptile avoids the gun. And then acid spit is a-coming. And look at these bubbles going, and that is a lot of chip adding up for Illusion's,
yes,
who also has the meter lead right now. Look, gave Sonic Fox an X-ray. Look at that. Perfect play from Illusion's. Complete turnaround. And looking good here.
Round two, fight.
I will say, I don't hate this pick right now. He's doing so well, ending every combo in the basket.
And a block breaker! What have we ever seen block breaker in MKX? We've seen it all, guys. Very good reversal from Sonic Fox. That was safe from Illusions, but safety doesn't mean everything because, exactly, if something's negative, there's respect there. That was a savage slide in from Illusions. And Basilisk's up raw in the slide. That's a
four-point. That could have been some huge damage.
She tries to Tatsu in, but he eats a coin for its efforts, and those are plus frames that Sonic Fox is going to use. And now has
the
corner.
Saw the grab coming.
Trying to block his way out as Illusions right now, and he ate both.
Went for the anti-air. Which, you know, Reptile doesn't really have an abundance of anti-airs.
Yeah, really his best option is an early down two there. Doesn't want to deal with that gap. Illusions now has got to be worried. He got back to the corner against Sonic Fox, and we've seen Sonic in the corner with Aaron Black do some of the most miraculous things in this game.
Just slides out of there. I like that. He didn't have the meter to stop it. If he did, that would have been some good damage, and Sonic has pretty much tied the health up.
Runs into a sand grenade. Now Sonic Fox has the corner. And press he tries to raw slide. If he would have meter burned the slide instead. Oh my gosh. And now Sonic Fox takes the lead. 2-1 over Illusions. And Illusions has to be thinking so.
This one's tricky, man.
If this goes to a game five, expect both of us to start freaking out.
Definitely. Very good. Illusions. Got him with the claw.
Oh, and one with the fast EX acid bubble. Wow. Very ready to see that. And that's not pressing a button. With that
swag, boy.
34%, and then the meaty acid bubble like that from Illusions just to try to continue either pressure or build the chip with the acid. Right there. Illusion pressing the button. Probably trying to slide out the gap. He's gonna get a conversion here.
He capitalized off that and he whiffs.
I think that.
And he got caught.
If Illusions would have just quick risen and not gone for the dash, that would have been a much easier conversion. Oh! Savagely throws the skull, but Sonic Fox reacting to the acid bubble slides his way in. He's just trying to slide his way into Illusions' DMs right now at this point. And big damage here. Sonic Fox is now running away with week 10 of the Combat Cup. He is now one combo away.
And down one. Into the grab, and that is a down one punish. Zangrenade swag into the grab. That will close it out.
And Sonic Fox is going to be your week 10 champion, going to Gunslinger of all variations. Thought long to be dead, but from day one, Sonic Fox Aaron with Gunslinger Black has wins. Been, and Aaron Black in general has Eight been talent. The showbringer. An achievement is named after this combo, guys. Sonic Fox misses the hidden brutality there at the end, but you know what? It's okay. You won Combat Cup this week. It's okay.